What's up, guys? It's your boy, Chance the Gamer here, back on Madden 17 Career Mode. It's week 15 as we battle the Philadelphia Eagles, Chris Stanker's team. Now we're at 26 touchdowns, meaning they get two more rushing touchdowns to tie and three to break LT's record. And you got a couple weeks left to do it, a few more games left to do it. So let's go into the Eagles game and see how we can do. And about the Packers game with the Falcons, I am absolutely stunned by that outcome because I did not expect them to. I did not expect them to win at all. I mean, I expected the Falcons to put up a fight, but I didn't expect the Falcons to just, you know, cream them as easily as they did. So the fact that they won as easy as they did, it's just crazy, man. It's absolutely crazy. Just looking through the Eagles jerseys, and let's get it started. All right, so week 15 will be coming at you. Trying to go 14-0. Of course, two touchdowns shy of tying with Ladainian Tomlinson's rushing yards. Touchdown record for the season. We're trying to break that. I mean, Cracky Gilmore's already set the record for most receptions in a single season. He passed Marvin Harrison, so he's got that record to his name. So who knows? We'll see what happens. We shall see what happens here in week number 15. Ravens trying to go 14-0. Eagles trying to go 8-5-1. They're the only other team with a tie. There's one other team that has, I can't remember who it was, but in any case, there is a tie on the record with the Eagles, but week 15 ought to be a good one, and I'm ready to go for some more football action, see if we can't go 14-0. Week 15 will be starting right about now.
Hello everybody, I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. It was a tremendous passing display that this man put on last week.
I can, you know?
Short, deep, intermediate. He made all the throws. And he had the yards to prove it, not to mention the win. He's riding high coming into this game. It's the Eagles going up against the Ravens.
And we got another sunny ball game.
Week 15 matchup. Here are Brandon Gunn and Charles Davis.
Larry, seems like it's never rainy or anything in Baltimore.
The NFL brings us to the Inner Harbor and M&T Bank Stadium in Baltimore, Maryland. Today, we reach week 15, and we've got a good matchup in
maybe after I got the Ravens to Super Bowl win, I'll do one for the Eagles. Who knows? We'll see. Ravens.
Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, and Charles, you look at this Raven team as they get ready here.
Looks like the Eagles get the ball first.
All year long as they hit the home stretch at 13-0.
And now they just have to guard against complacency. You still got to go out and earn it every week.
Yep, looks like Ravens or Eagles get the ball first. So we'll be back to start this in just a second. Okay, Eagles get first crack. Let's see what they do. First play after Darren Fields with the first touchback. Ryan Matthews, 3-yard rush. Brandon Williams injured on the play, not good. Second and 7, knocked away. Third and 7, dropped by Brent Selleck. We get the ball. And I'm happy to report that Kamari Aiken is back. Tyler Gronkowski threw on 11 touchdown record, 17 touchdowns for receiving Rex being confidence. And Kamari Aiken there is back after missing most of the last game with that PCL sprain.
They'll come out throwing here.
Going to Crockett right away.
Caught left side, Gilmore.
Nice shot, bud. Take it down shy. Give me 7 more yards.
At the 46. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Crockett, of course, already has the record for most receptions in the season, so why don't you just add to that?
Chains here, second and 3. They're set up to throw.
You never expect the tight end to be the type that would set a record like that, but he did. We just missed that completion, so we're 1 out of 2. Let's go FL and
Gunn. 3 full yards here for the offense to get on third down.
Indianapolis 5-8. Arizona 12-1. Damn. They are rolling this year. I don't know what I was doing throwing that one.
Had his hands on it, but couldn't
pick it. I got so into throwing to Crockett there, or Max Williams, I just threw it to the wrong guy. I should have just thrown it to Aiken, but in any case, they get the ball back. Yard rush, 3rd and 2, square rush. Yeah, I'm just gonna rely on Matthew probably to get me yardage. 3rd and 6, incomplete again. So our ball once again.
And the Ravens taking the field. And a 3 and out On that first drive, we'll see if they can do better here.
They should have a better opportunity because the nerves should be settled now. That first series, everybody
gets nice catch. Oh, Crockett had it. He couldn't hold on
to
it.
So now they get a chance to go back out. Yeah, big deal. Okay, now we're into the game. Let's go play.
Go play
the best we can.
You almost get a mulligan then on that first drive.
Sometimes it absolutely serves that way. You get a second opportunity. Nothing big happened. But then again, you didn't come.
That was pass. I'm just going to run.
Off you go.
He could have went all the way there. Look at that, 25-yard rush.
A really nice gain of 25 yards.
Nicely done. 25-yard gains are always welcome.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels.
Let's go! What? Nine!
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw.
Rocket, he's open. He's got space. Nice job. 2 out of 5 for Minchie Nash.
Midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. And now, partner, he has surpassed Marvin Harrison's record for most catches in a single season. He's got 144.
It's amazing. He almost did it quietly because Marvin Harrison wasn't a guy that we saw much in the media. But boy, did he produce. Now, he steps aside. Marvin Harrison is number 2. We were here today to see the new number 1.
He's been past that. Where are you going? He's been past that. Where are they at?
Put them in a bad spot here.
Yeah, he only gets a few yards on first and 10, but he's better off doing that than throwing an incompletion or even worse, an interception.
Quick dump off fast as he's
Smith. Only 3 yards on the catch.
Okay, 3rd and 6. So the Eagles are definitely playing the they're playing a defensive game, that's for sure. And a 7-5 in the game.
Eagles,
they're probably make the playoffs.
DB here as they prepare for a stop on third.
Thinking pass all the way.
Caught it. Nice job there. My Max Williams to make the big catch. Nice going, buddy. Nice going. I don't pass it to him often, but he just came through big for me. And we'll be back for more action right after this. And we're back, ready for more.
Chains pick up first downs. A nice job finding an open receiver for a completion.
They'll look to throw now on first down. Eluding the pressure right. And no escaping this time. It's him.
Okay, so I finally get sacked and so I just lost 7 yards.
And plays like that really hurt play calling. They had a really nice gain on the previous play, but gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure.
That's all right, though. We'll be all right.
The football. Down he goes.
Going to Stevie. Double coverage. Dangerous. And incomplete.
Incomplete.
So I lost 7 yards because probably total offense just got lost, but that's okay. I'll be all right.
And the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
And some secondary help here for the defense and the nickel on third and long.
Looking Esther might have a step. Makes a catch. Did he stay in bounds? Yes, he did. Touchdown!
Devin Hester.
That's my 70th passing TD of the year. Holy shit.
And the Ravens have taken the early lead.
Now, I knew the record was 54, but I never thought I'd throw for 70. God damn. I'll take it, though. We now lead it 7-0. I would prefer a rushing touchdown, but I'll take a passing one. I'll never say no to passing touchdowns. Second and 10, knocked away. Third and 10, incomplete again. All right, our ball. Let's go for verticals.
Now the Baltimore offense heading back out onto the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on
all
the last
marks.
Drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be.
And guys got a big yardage right there, baby.
And continue to do
there's
so.
55 yards, 29-yard run.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went. No
keep it rushing, baby. Keep it going.
And no big plays by the defense.
Keep his feet
a
churning.
Partner, it's often the man coverage is easier for a quarterback to run against. You get your receivers going downfield. Those guys are staying with them, and oftentimes they have
another 13 yards.
The quarterback, which opens up a lot of space and room, and they don't even know that he's taking off with it. What a big time.
160 yards, all right.
To throw here on first down.
Okay, nice catch.
Here by Gilmore. And on this one, he'll get to the 15.
There's another
7
yards.
Give him 7 on the play, and it'll make it a second down.
Still wide dig.
Back to throw here.
Wish we didn't have to take such a steep drop, but whatever.
So quick on the spin. Nice spinning, man. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the three.
Man, rush for 81 yards. We're gunning for that touchdown to get LT's record. I want LT's record. I'll do whatever I have to get this.
Practice field this week.
I'll do whatever I have to get that touchdown, to get that record.
They've been prepping for. They'll look to throw. And he will score.
I'm just like, okay, nobody's going to be open. I'll just run into myself.
It's their quarterback with his second touchdown of this opening quarter. And the Ravens will add on.
Adam make it 14-0. Way to go, boys. We'll be back for more right after this. Okay, guys, let's keep this on going. There you go, kick, first and 10. Finally, they get a big pass after Ryan Matthews. Negative 2-yard rush, second and 12. Negative 3-yard rush. And first quarter, third and 15, 4-yard rush. So they got to punt it away again.
The Ravens offense now, they get set to head back on the
They finally
field.
Get some advantage, and then they have to, you know,
drive. They did it all on the ground, Charles. And they controlled it from the interior. Big on
oh,
the
shit. I was afraid of that.
Intercepted, picked off by Nolan Carroll.
This will for sure get them a touch. This will for sure get them a touchdown. But considering how much we were jammed in there, I kind of really felt they had no choice but to just kind of throw something. Because I didn't think I'd be able to get out of there without getting sacked and take a safety. I might as well just take the points for Philly. It's now 14-7.
And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last
touch. Right to Steve Smith.
Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens.
There you
5
go.
Yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
Brandon, I love how in the game of football, everything that we call new, if we research it, we find out it's old. Mobile quarterbacks have been around forever. Those who can extend a play and find open receivers downfield. Those guys
okay.
Never get old.
Ah.
And his throw here's
damn, but he had that one.
As tight ends go, he might not provide the super flashy plays.
Go where a good old flanker drive.
He's pretty reliable, usually an excellent target, and normally catches what's thrown to him, but he didn't on that play.
He'll look to throw.
Crockett's got his this guy's cut. Easy play.
And he's got the first down yardage as he brings this up to the 47.
8-14 over 100 yards.
So he makes the grab and the chains move forward.
Nice job by the offensive line giving
track.
Them time to complete that first down pass.
Hey, go down. Let's go! Ryan 38!
Now a play fake here on first down. Sliding out of the pocket.
Oh, I got hit in that throw.
Complete as he was knocked as he threw it. And it took the ball off course.
Yeah, I need to get rid of all of that for, you know,
sometimes you want
to need to let, put all my strength behind that, and I couldn't do it.
I don't know exactly how this one was designed. Made sure they moved him to his right. He got out of the pocket. Unfortunately for him, he was hit as he tried to throw the ball, and that resulted
going deep.
In
come on!
Now he's going to throw deep right side.
He could have had that, too.
The ball away and it falls
I hate when that happens. You know, you throw a bomb deep and then, you know, anytime
you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
On play action, they'll throw. Escaping
going
the
deep.
Pressure right. Now he'll let it go deep right side.
Got to punt it away, whatever.
And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings
fourth and 10, whatever. Kick it away. See what happens with them. 5-yard rush, second and one. They're probably going to score again. I hate when I'm right on these kind of calls, but fortunately they don't. Get it punted away.
And all right. Here come the Ravens.
9:42 left in the second.
After punting last time, see if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going
extra
on
catch.
Offense right now.
And I get the yard. And I get the yard. Maybe he lost the yard.
Panic creep in and affect their
I don't know if he made a play or if he lost anything there.
It'll be second down. Pass completion for no gain, not something you want to call up out of the playbook too often.
Yeah, most offensive coordinators don't have that on their play sheet, so they've got to go back and scramble after this one. But right now, with what they're telling receivers about making sure you take
make
care
the
of the
catch,
ball
bro.
Field, sometimes the fighting
get open and make the catch
doesn't come as a result. That and good tackling can lead to no yards
gained. All right,
gained.
Well, let's do that.
Third down, a nickel formation here defensively. They'll drop to throw.
He's going deep, ball to the step. Ah, he had a step, but I threw it to like 9 of 20. Gotta put it away again. Sheesh, we can't seem to get anything going right now. We're struggling. Struggling on offense to get anything going. Fortunately, so is silly. And we'll be back for more right after this. Alright, let's keep on rolling. Running a good old slot drive play.
The Ravens offense now, they
keep popping up the thing for getting Crockett stuff, but I don't want to get it away to him. Nice catch there, Crockett. Nice job. 14 more yards.
They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone. And a nice pitch and catch to pick up the reception against man coverage.
Both of them read how much yardage they needed, figured what they had to do, and were able
to beat the man coverage for the completion. On first down, he'll drop to throw.
Kind of threw it early, and I almost got paid for it. I'm going to pay for it.
It would have been his second pick of the game. Instead, it'll be second down.
I might have let go of it a little early, but, you know,
second down
whatever.
After the incomplete pass.
As long as I don't get hurt for it, doesn't matter. See if I get Aiken a step downfield.
Off the play fake. He'll
oh, yeah, he's definitely
throw.
Got a step.
He's going to air one out.
Aiken! You got to make that catch, buddy.
That's a pretty play right there. And what I'm
thankful
for is it wasn't me in that situation. Because one of the toughest things about defending the deep ball is not panicking. Because the longer you run with a receiver, you're trying to figure out, am I close to him? Can I make a play?
Going all the way across the field.
Yeah. For Smith, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Malcolm Jenkins.
I probably shouldn't have thrown it as far as I did. In any case, I just do another interception. Gotta quit doing that. I want that rushing record. I thought I threw it across in the 90, so it's kind of, you know.
Here comes the Raven offense now.
Kind of like telegraph.
Possession. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game the team making the fewest mistakes.
I can't do anything right now.
What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches already turned two picks, but geez.
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
A play action fake. They'll look to throw. Rolling to his right.
Gotta get rid of it before I was ready. Esther can't make the play. Of course he can't.
Not only did he drop it, he dropped it in the end zone.
Had to throw it before I was ready.
Not quite sure how he wasn't able to hold on to that one in the end zone. A great opportunity lost, but a lot of relief for the defensive guys. When they get into film next week, they're going to want to know what happened. Where was the breakdown that almost allowed a touchdown?
So I just overthrew him. There on third down, just overthrew him there. And one touchdown, two picks. I'm not doing that great so far, but we'll be alright. If we can keep this up, if we can keep up the way we're playing lately, we'll be fine. We should be fine.
And the Ravens taking the field. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
Can't seem to really get going here.
And go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense.
Time to run.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what
you've got some yardage.
Realize it hasn't worked so well. And maybe try and find one of those special plays.
At least I got something.
Better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the
excitement. I'm not really getting much in terms of passing. I got to run.
They'll look to throw here on first
down. Aiken, nice catch.
And he works it to the 30-yard line here.
Right 128, 122 yards, one TD, two picks.
For three and it's second down.
Obviously, I'm going to be MVP, but still, considering I've been throwing picks like crazy in these last two games, you got to do better than that.
We're back to Baltimore after this. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes' time, we'll hand you off to Orlando, where Larry Ridley will have highlights and analysis of this first
half. I'm not going to worry about that.
Stiff-armed him. And down inside the
field. Yeah, I wasn't gonna worry about pass. I'm just gonna run. Just run. Nice job, boys. We'll be back for more right after this. Alright, we're back. Let's see if we can't get a score. Good strong play. Hell with Crockett, we're probably gonna try to run it in.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Flush to his right. And no escaping this time.
That's the second time I've gone down.
Got him for a sack. A first-time Pro Bowler from 2015, Fletcher Cox, in there to get him for sack number 9 now on the year. They'll set up a throw. Steps away to his left.
As you can see, there's nobody over on the left-hand side. And touchdown. I knew running to the right side wouldn't work, so I had to go left.
Agile quarterback on his way to a monster game. 3 first-half touchdowns. And the Ravens
just like whoosh, and there's a score. So we finally got the second rushing TD. Now we're tied with LT. Now we just need one more. Just need one more. Over the record. We lead 21-7 at the end of the first half. Not to mention the fact that we get the ball to start the second half. Cool. Second and 10, 4 yards. Third and 6, incomplete. Okay, let's go flanker drive, see if we can't get something going here.
Get set to take the field. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
Whoops, I got hit hard.
Counterpunch, isn't it?
Down
there
you go.
Which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back.
Right to the turf.
Time on offense, they rolled downfield, get to a good rhythm. You see a little
slot
bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with.
Going deep. He's got it. He's got a score. Hester Sr., there's a touchdown, baby.
Ravens touchdown. Devin Hester with his second TD of the game, his sixth on the year.
Way to go, Hester. That's how you do it, buddy. It's Nathan catch and just running in for a free fall. No, it's 28-7. Way to go, boys. Not only that, we get the ball to start in the second half. Wenzel Neal, and we start the third quarter. We'll be back for more right after this. All right, got the first possession in the third quarter. Let's see what we can do, people.
Ravens now, they'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them.
Oh, there goes another sack. That's the third time I've gone down.
Brandon Graham in there.
I gotta quit getting sacks, bro.
Time this year as he continues what could be a record-setting season.
Let's go.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Dancing to his left. What a spin. It's a gain of 7, and it'll be
10
a
rushes, 140 yards.
13.
2 touchdowns. Not too bad so far, not too bad. It's a good play action Raven shot.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Yeah, they've got an extra defensive back out there now on 3rd and 13. Now back to throw.
Going deep.
He'll buy some time.
Hey, Jen, make that catch. Damn it.
And it's knocked away. Complete.
No big deal. Fourth down, just kick it away. 3rd and 4. 15 in front of the defense. That doesn't help our cause. 2nd and 6, -2 yard rush. 3rd and 9, incomplete pass. 4th and 9, they kick the field goal. It's now 28-10. Play action, all go.
Baltimore gets set to take the field.
This should be an interesting setup. Let's see what we can do.
Here we go.
Aiken.
They go play action here on first down. They'll roll.
Aiken has a step. I'm going as deep as I can.
Deep right side.
Drops
down incomplete.
Aiken, you have got to make that catch, bro.
Second down.
Can't just let me throw it deep and then you not catch it.
Coordinator, every play caller sheet. They have about 5 or 6 plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays, and you don't get many opportunities to dial them up, and they just did, and they dropped.
Going deep, Smithy.
Big play.
Yep.
That's gonna hurt.
Brilliant defensive play. I'm not mad about that.
And incomplete.
We all know how important momentum is in a game, and when an offense decides to take a deep shot downfield, they're trying to create a big play and put doubt in the defense's mind the rest of the ball game. And in this case, the defense won the battle, batted the ball away deep downfield. So guess what? The momentum now quickly shifted from the offense taking the
shot.
Having
it rush is 150 yards.
Knocking it
away. That's first down,
baby. And now they feel like they might be
first down.
And now they're in the hurry up. Now a play fake here on first down.
Steve Smith. He's got it. Wait, no, he doesn't. I thought I had it, but he's going to hold on to it. 12-34. Wow, our passing thing is nasty. Our passing percentage is terrible. 35%. And again, Carson Wentz ain't that great. Carson Wentz ain't that great. Okay, so that doesn't matter. How bad ours is. I practically threw that right into the arm of the defender. How have they been sticking that off?
His team's already picked off two passes. That would have been the third in the game. And boy,
come on, boys, gotta focus.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw.
Going deep.
Right. That was going to let it go deep right. And that is intercepted on the sideline. Wait, no. They'll say no.
Okay, thankfully it's an incomplete pass, so they punt it away again. And they get the ball, and immediately. Okay, I get a couple yardage, first and 10. Dropped. Second and 10. 5-yard rush. Third and 5. 9-yard pass. They're moving upfield pretty quickly. Third and 1. And they turn it over somehow.
And now Baltimore gets
they turned it over four times. We've only turned it over twice.
And they'll be looking to avoid what happened last time, which is punting the football.
But when you look at how teams play the game, that complimentary football.
And it's catch. Play, I'm only going to hear. We'll be back from all over right after this. Well, like I said, guys, some days it's just not that good fast and ball.
The defense is taking care of them in a lot of ways. Now it's time for the offense to jump things up and help their defense out. Give them a little bit of rest.
Yeah, time for them to give them a rest. Took the words right out of my mouth.
Let's go!
He'll look to throw.
Bracket's open. He's going to have space. And he's got the first.
He's out of bounds on the other side of midfield. They pick up 12 on the play there.
Nice going.
The chains.
That's a good old flanker drive.
The quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there, and how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end, let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets
Aiken, nice job. There's that first.
Want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
And he's brought down 11 yards.
Now we're finally getting more accuracy.
It's a nice completion, a little bit of run after catch as well to create the yardage that they got. But it is so tough to cover that route, the drag route.
15 out of 39 passing. That's nasty.
The key is to create hesitancy on the defender's part.
Always so empathetic for those DBs, aren't you? Oh, nice spin.
Oh, that brought back bad memories.
And he's going to get this inside.
There you go. That's how you rush it.
Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
Score weak flood.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here. To throw now on first down.
Easy
and he's
catch.
His favorite target yet again. It's complete. A gain of 6 there.
Like I said,
first.
Only 16 and 40, but at least we're getting complete touchdowns and completions more consistently now.
Hey, here we go.
They'll set up to throw.
Make the catch. Can't quite get the first.
That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
Third and 2. Good old flanker drive.
Play number 6 on this drive.
Watch eight. Let's go. 1, 9.
They'll go to the air here on 3rd and 2. Flushed out right. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. John Harbaugh going to roll the dice. They're going for it on 4th down.
Going for it for a reason because I know I can make this. I had to run because I thought I could get the rushing, but I'm going for the pass. And we got the first with these.
And he takes it down to the 13 and picks up the first. 7 yards on the play, and they're able to pick up the conversion here on 4th down.
And I'm just that good.
The attempt was well in hand. They had that, but they decided to go for it anyway. Extreme confidence, it looks like.
Yeah, but I bet the defense is going to remember this one, right? They kind of rubbed their nose in it. They showed
off another
the
9 yards.
Athletic juke. Good little gain there. Not a whole lot of real estate.
So he can't get another.
Nice carry.
Matt, do not start the 4th. We'll see. Depends if I can snap it fast enough. Nope, got one more play left in the 3rd. And we're not quite going to get there unless I can pass this guy. Nope. No guys. Who cares? Who cares? We're fine.
We're off to the 4th quarter here in week 15. Happy holidays to all. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Who cares? We are A-OK. rolling, guys.
Back now in Baltimore.
We actually, well, that's interesting. That's the first time, I think that's the first time we've ever been held scoreless in a quarter. Interesting. Anyways, we'll be back for more right after this. Alright, here we go. Let's start the fourth quarter. Let's see if we can't get something going here. Let's go smash Texas, see if we can't get that score.
Play after play on this long drive for the offense. They'll look to throw for it on third and one. Flush to his right. And he's going to go.
Yeah, go down again.
Outside of the five, right around the 6 yard line.
Smash Texas one more time.
Staying out. They're going to go on fourth and two. Back to throw here. Forced out to his
right. I saw an opening. I think I got it.
For it and he will.
Did I get it?
Not nope. To go for it this
I thought I got it, but no dice. I got 2 yards, but apparently they said it wasn't enough. Whatever. But they immediately turned it over anyway, so that's good for me.
And now Baltimore gets set to take the field. They had a great drive going last time. They were moving the ball, and then all of a sudden it just stalled out. So we'll see what they can do here, Charles.
And it's always easy to second
guess. Oh, what was I doing throwing that?
But they had to like the feeling that they had going on offense. They want to continue.
Why did I throw that? It was like I threw it right at him.
This drive and maybe get in the same position.
Yeah, and that's, I mean, like I said, they were moving the football. It's not like they went four and out, so I don't think it's a deal where the offense doesn't have confidence.
No, I agree. Catch the Crockett. If anything, they made
another 7 yards.
Confidence. Okay, they stopped us once. That's all right. Let's keep moving it.
They don't have any touchdowns this week. Big numbers.
A repeat performance. It seems right now it doesn't matter how many guys they're going to put on him. He's going to catch the football.
And when you hit that zone, and that's what he's in right now,
we're doing rolling.
Everything is working well for him, and I think it's in combination
Stevie,
with
somebody.
He's a primary.
Okay, there's a flag. There's a flag. There's a flag. That could help us out.
And has designed some routes.
Who is it? Who's it on? Give it to me. Tell me who it is.
Really been fun to watch.
Okay, holding on the defense. Great. First and ten.
Handsy there, defensive holding, Charles.
And automatic first down.
Get away with as much as you will allow. The 5 yard mark tells the officials where the line should be drawn.
They go play action here on first down. Deep drop. Now he's flushed out right.
Mosley, right to you. Oh, how did he not catch that?
Collision there, jarred the ball loose and brings
19-45, I think it is. Jeez, we are terrible passing today.
And on second and ten now.
I mean, 19 out of 45. That's only 42% passing. Then again, sometimes players don't have to be accurate to be successful.
They'll look to throw again.
Aiken, all you buddy.
Catch left side here by Aiken.
And there's your first down.
10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh shut it down.
Season rank total defense is 5. Right? 380 yards today.
So they're operating in the red zone.
Passed 46 times, rushed 14 times.
To throw now on first down, eluding the
just dump it off
right. Underneath he hits for Sam, just a 1 yard pickup on the play, and
like I said, I probably wasn't gonna get anywhere, so I'm like, okay, just dump it off.
How these guys on plays just like dump the ball off, get out of the pocket, keep plays alive. It just makes things so much harder for defenses.
It really does. And we're talking about an era in the game where the quarterbacks are the most athletically gifted that we've seen.
15 rush 138 yards, very few season rank. Russian defense is 6 to them.
So
128
is practice now. It's not necessarily, oh, he just took off and you guys figure it out. When he takes off, everyone knows where to go now. They know how to run routes, change things, make themselves presentable for the quarterback. That's a lot of
time. I'm rushing for it. I'm not gonna let this get away from it.
1, 2, 3, this is where the ball goes anymore.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Being chased.
Such a heavy drop. There was no way I could get out of there.
He's brought down.
If it wasn't such a heavy drop, I probably could have managed it, but because it was such a heavy drop, there was no way I was getting out of that. 15 penalty against the D, they'll probably score. Another penalty. Second and 10. They will probably score. By their rush. And they do. So now it's 28-17. That's fine.
Now the Baltimore offense heading back out onto the field. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches?
What are you doing?
Complimentary football. Offense take care.
What are you doing there, bro?
Defense take care.
What are you doing?
Offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them.
That should have been easy play.
Back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover.
Smith, go for a big bomb.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. He's going to sling this deep downfield.
Ah, another incompletion.
It falls in.
Come on.
There's no shyness there pushing the ball downfield, but I like the coverage on the play. In good position.
And
when you have a 50-50 ball, who's going to come down with it? I like the way they made the play. Came across and knocked it away.
Sliding out of the pocket. Incomplete.
21 of 50. Damn. Put it away again, and we'll be back for more. Okay, 3 and out again here in the fourth. Hopefully the Eagles don't do anything with the ball. We should be okay. And they don't do anything with it. Good.
And now Baltimore gets set to take the field. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule.
It's like I threw it right at him. Why did he not catch that?
Consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. He'll try again with the arm here on second down. Buying time to his left. Look at the spin. And they're able to get this
good yardage on that rush.
35. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the
5 yards after contact. Let's go bench play.
The offense lining up first and 10.
Okay, I'm not going to hit Stevie. Maybe we'll crack it again. We'll see. Crockett's the one that's open. Oh, that was serious.
But it's incomplete.
And that one was
Crockett was open, but they got knocked away.
The defender's going to be a little upset with themselves. They made the play on the football, but that one felt like a forced pass by the quarterback. Thought he had someone open. He really wasn't. Maybe an example of having too much confidence in his receiver that no matter what, I'm going to throw
Moss it. Has it, and he's got the first. Almost.
And it could have been a bigger one.
They'll get 9 there as that sets them up better for third down.
Thank you, drive.
Third down and 1.
Hopefully we can at least hit 300 yards passing because we should have that right now.
They'll look to throw.
Deep drop. Nobody's blocking that side of the field. I'm going.
He may try and run for this. Look at the dance and the juke. And he'll get this one down.
Well, if nobody's gonna block that side of the field, I'm just gonna run. That's our 30th rush of 20 yards or more this year. Holy shit. That's insane.
So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve.
Like I said, if they aren't gonna guard that side of the field, I'm just gonna take off.
They'll look to throw now on first down.
They're probably expecting it. Nakin makes the catch.
And eventually
nice job, buddy.
Down, but it's near the 5 at the 6. It's a really
way to go, bud. Way to go.
Pick up, and now it's first and
we'll be back for more right after this. Okay, we're in position to get that record set and touchdown. Let's go get it.
Pretty good route combination there because you've got to find a way to clear the guy running the drag. Because when you do, you just put the ball on him and then let him run.
Yeah, he's got some space. Now a play fake here on first down. Escaping the pressure right.
Into the end zone. He's got it. There it is. Record breaker.
It's their quarterback. A 6-yard touchdown run. And the Ravens will extend.
That is it. Number 29.
Zone, and in this one, he's sort of carrying the team on his back.
He's the reason that they...
That sets the record. Most in a season. I just broke LT's mark. Hope my buddy in San Diego is okay with that, because I just broke LaTanian Tomlinson's season touchdown record. Alright, second and 17, incomplete. Third and 17, 5-yard pass, and they probably have a turnover. Play action spot, let's
Baltimore
get the 4 first downs.
To take the field. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out when they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once,
you're going blitz, make the catch. Nice job.
Again, doesn't matter what the defense throws at them.
Nice job, buddy.
Move right now.
They got 35 points today.
Yeah, we're going to stay in that groove here this go around.
Recent play, let's go back and cross the wheel again. We're almost there. Almost to that promised land at the 14-0 victory.
He'll look to throw.
Stevie's there. At least he was there.
Incomplete.
give him credit for batting it away, but
just on the run, couldn't make the catch.
Interception, and sometimes that joke does come true. Guys are on defense for a reason. Maybe their hands aren't quite as skillful as the guys on offense, but a lot of credit on that play for just knocking it away.
They'll set up a throw.
Aikens got it. Nice job.
Kamara Aiken. And he's got enough for the first across midfield to the 48.
And Brandon, I can grab again. In college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. And he gets this inside
the 20 rushes, 240 yards, 3 touchdowns.
15 yards there on the scramble and a first down.
We're rolling, Nerdy. Let's keep it going. Maybe get that third first down. Maybe get another touchdown and ensure they are buried. Got him pretty much buried now. Want to ensure they're buried. Nice catch there by Aiken. Yeah, about 9 yards, I'd say.
Break one tackle, quickly brought down, but a nice little game. Call it a pickup of 7, and that'll make it.
I haven't thrown as many as I did last
guy,
week.
I don't know that you're surprised when he has back-to-back games like this. He just keeps excelling.
Yeah, you keep excelling, but I would like to have more yardage.
He doesn't settle for being one of the best in the game. He tries to make
it all good.
Better. Almost like those great basketball players. I remember hearing about Kobe Bryant wanting to add something to his game every offseason.
Whoa, where did he come from? Well, in any case, we'll be back for more right after this. Okay, anyways, we got the win, 14-0 over the Eagles. We did absolutely brilliant work. Cracky Gilmore got another big score. And in our next episode, we'll be looking to go 60-0 against the hated Pittsburgh Steelers. So until next time, it's Roy Charms of the Gamers handing out. Remember to make sure to like, comment, and subscribe to the channel. Smash that like button as hard as you possibly can. And, you know, if you guys are enjoying the series, let me know in the comments. Anyways, that last touchdown was a quick one to Crockett Gilmore. That made it 42-17. That's how we wrapped it up. So, till next time, peace out, everybody. Love y'all.